Did you know that the same diet used to treat seizures in epilepsy and used for weight loss is now being studied in Parkinson's disease? What if food is powerful enough to actually help protect your brain cells? Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Tidman, and welcome back to the channel where we explore natural approaches to chronic conditions and Parkinson's disease. If you've watched my channel for a while, you'll remember that I am a clinical researcher in Parkinson's disease and metabolic health. Chronic diseases such as diabetes, osteoporosis, and metabolic syndrome. So thanks for stopping by. Today we're going to break down some research that was published in the Asian Journal of Allied Health Science on the therapeutic effects of ketogenic diets in Parkinson's. You'll also be able to go on my channel and view some of my own clinical research presentations on the 5 studies that I have published in use of this approach in Parkinson's disease. Many of you will remember that my 6th study is in data collection right now in 2025, and I hope to have that study published in 2026. So, what is Parkinson's disease? Why so much interest in nutrition and brain health? And is it true that many patients are now seeking more natural approaches to deal with their Parkinson's disease in addition to their medications? So the research study I'm going to be reviewing was by Basharat et al., done in 2019. They really investigated the therapeutic effects of the components of a ketogenic diet. And their focus was on Parkinson's disease and brain energy metabolism. To review, Parkinson's disease is a progressive brain disorder caused by a loss of dopamine-producing neurons. Some of the symptoms include tremors, stiffness, slow movement, and sometimes changes in memory and cognition. Medications can help, but they don't stop the disease, and rarely do they address the non-motor symptoms. Non-motor symptoms in Parkinson's include sleep dysregulation, depression or anxiety, loss of motivation to participate in social settings, apathy, sometimes with severe symptoms like hallucinations. Since the medications don't really address the non-motor symptoms, researchers are interested in exploring natural strategies like nutrition that target the brain's energy systems. This is what Basharat et al. Was investigating, and it's what I investigate in the studies that I conduct in Parkinson's disease. So let's review, what is the ketogenic diet? Now, if you've watched others of my videos, you are experts on what's part of this diet. But if you have not seen them, go back and look at a lot of my videos on ketogenic nutrition. Ketogenic nutrition in Parkinson's, in other health conditions. There are a variety of videos available for you. So ketogenics use high fat, low carb, and moderate protein consumption. The goal is to produce ketones to fuel your brain, but we also know that the heart loves ketones, the liver loves them, and the kidneys love them. So a lot of our major organ systems love to work off of ketones as their fuel source. Originally, this approach was used in epilepsy. Actually, it's been used for over 100 years in treatment of seizures and epilepsy. Can you imagine if this approach is powerful enough to get rid of seizures in someone with epilepsy, how powerful could it be for your brain that has experienced loss of dopamine and the onset of Parkinson's disease? This approach is being studied in many neurodegenerative conditions like Alzheimer's, MS, ALS, and Huntington's disease. Of course, we know that this is the fastest way to get rid of your diabetes, to put your diabetes in remission. In fact, in the patients that I treat, I can basically help them get off diabetes medications and regulate their blood sugar within about 6 to 8 weeks. Again, loss of dopamine neurons in the brain is a hallmark feature of a Parkinson's diagnosis. Dysfunction in the mitochondria in the brain, which are the powerhouse energy producing organelles, small areas of each cell. And of course, we know that high oxidative stress plays a big role in neurodegeneration. The brain is very hypersensitive to inflammation and oxidative stress. So the key findings were that as the body produced ketones as an alternative fuel source, this fuel became more relevant in the brain when glucose metabolism was impaired. And often, especially in conditions like Alzheimer's, we see that glucose metabolism is impaired. So the brain needs an alternative fuel source. We also know that there are three main ways to increase ketones in your bloodstream. You've heard these before on my channel. Using MCT oil will increase your ketone production, along with exogenous ketone supplementation. This can increase your blood ketones considerably. Consuming a ketogenic diet with high fats and very low carbohydrates will increase your ketone production. And of course, fasting, which has been used in human beings to treat disease for thousands of years. There are writings from as far back as Hippocrates in using fasting to treat disease. Ketosis reduces oxidative stress and the creation of something we call reactive oxygen species and inflammatory cytokines. These are molecules of inflammation, and they are reduced in the presence of ketosis, and that is when you can get your blood ketones above 0.5 millimolar. How do you know where your ketones are? Well, of course, you've heard me tell you to obtain a blood glucose and ketone meter and test your blood in the morning while you're fasted. We also know that ketones help improve mitochondrial efficiency. So ketones have a huge effect on metabolic health and neurological health in Parkinson's. This is kind of a complicated schematic, but basically what it shows is that the ketogenic diet promotes lipolysis, the breakdown of fats, and these fats then turn into or become free fatty acids, which are taken up by the liver. And then the liver creates some precursors to beta hydroxybutyrate, which is the blood ketone molecule. And then through the creation of beta hydroxybutyrate, this crosses the blood-brain barrier into the brain to provide an alternative fuel source. So that is a very simplified explanation of this very complex metabolic process. Here's a simpler way to think of it. glucose is trying to come into the cell to run the cell. But when glucose is not very prevalent or not abundant, or the cell is very dysregulated with obtaining and using glucose, probably due to insulin resistance and high insulin levels, then the ketones can enter the cell. As the ketones enter the cell, the mitochondria use those ketones to produce ATP, which is the energy molecule that fuels our cells and our systems in the body. Again, very simplified. There's a lot more to it than this, but I thought this schematic would help you kind of visualize what the ketones do. So what are some of the patient benefits that have been seen by Basharat and his colleagues and in other studies that study Parkinson's disease? We have found that the presence of ketones can potentially slow down the progression of your Parkinson's disease. In my first 12-week study on this approach, 30% of those participants actually reversed the stage of their disease when evaluated at baseline and at 12 weeks by a neurologist. They actually went from stage 2 to stage 1 or from stage 3 to stage 2. Now, 30% isn't a high number, and it was only a study involving 16 individuals, but there are other studies indicating that protective response of ketones in the brain. There have been many studies that have showed that increased ketones and the state of nutritional ketosis may improve movement and memory, cognition, thinking, higher process thinking, problem solving, reaction speed. We know that the presence of ketones in the blood supports the memory centers and energy in your brain, but we also see that it can support your own energy, your total body energy, and help to alleviate some of these prevalent fatigue symptoms that you all have. So the use of ketones, the ketogenic diet, does not replace your medication, but it complements or enhances your medication. In some of my studies, I've found that the presence of nutritional ketosis above 1.0 millimolar in the blood may help prolong the effects of your synthetic dopamine medication or allow you to go longer between doses. So it's a complement to your medication, not a replacement. So practical tips. Work with your healthcare provider on adjusting your medications when you make your dietary changes. Gradually reduce your processed carbohydrates and sugars and juices and sodas and grains in your diet. Consider adding those healthy fats, MCTs, coconut oil, olive oil, grass-fed butter, beef tallow and lard. Avocado oil is another one. Focus on nutrient-rich whole foods in their most natural forms. That's the produce aisle, the meat, fish, and poultry aisle, the dairy and egg aisle, and out you go. Monitor your symptoms and your energy levels, and monitor your blood numbers, your glucose, and your ketones while fasted in the mornings. So you can see in this study by Basharat, they were really looking at a patient-centered approach that was safe, and feasible. They found that there's a synergy, a working together of lifestyle interventions, nutrition interventions, and exercise. If you've watched some of my videos, you'll see that I am a proponent of all three of those working together, especially in Parkinson's disease, other neurodegenerative diseases, and other metabolic health conditions. So I wanted to provide you with some hope through some metabolic health strategies when dealing with your Parkinson's disease. There are things you can do. Stay informed on these natural approaches to Parkinson's symptoms. There are many videos on my channel, but there are also other metabolic health practitioners and researchers with excellent videos on this approach. I have created a Parkinson's research playlist for you. Go and check out the playlist, where I have also put kind of condensed in one area all of the research I've investigated and reviewed in Parkinson's. And remember, ketogenics, therapeutic carbohydrate reduction, therapeutic ketogenics, are a huge intervention that you can do at home that is powerful for your brain and your Parkinson's symptoms. The science is growing, and this research really does give us hope. This is the reference for the Basharat et al. Article, and I will post the link to the article in the description below. Thanks for stopping by, everyone. It's great to see you. Be sure to subscribe to my channel so you know when I'm posting future videos and research reviews. Remember, those of you with Parkinson's disease, there's hope through nutrition and lifestyle. Check out my channel and my Parkinson's research playlist, and I'll see you in the next video.